Devlina, welcoming you all to another Power Pack episode of Icons Behind Brand video interview series, Marketing Today and Tomorrow. And in today's episode, we have with us Mr. Sanjeev Shukla. Mr. Shukla has been a marketing and corporate strategy leader with an experience of almost 3 decades in the ad world, and he has worked in mega corporates like Hyundai Motors, Hero MotoCorp, Ford Motors, and he is known and awarded for historic launch of Hyundai Motors in India and for the historic launch of one of the celebrated launches and brands in India across industries ever, the Hyundai Centro, as a founder member and as a founder marketing lead of Hyundai Motors India. He is currently a founder and director of Terra Health. It is lovely to have you on board with us, Mr. Shukla.
Thank you, Devlina.
A warm welcome to you. We are glad to have you on with us here.
Thank you.
So, Mr. Shukla, almost 3 decades into the business of marketing, advertising, and branding, and you have worked with mega companies like Ford, Hero MotoCorp, Hyundai Motors in positions like head of marketing, group CMO. You know, so what, got striked to start your own? I mean, what made you think to start your own organization? We would love to know about your journey and background. What was the inspiration behind that?
Yeah, thanks, Devlina. First of all, thank you very much to having me here. It tends to fulfill the function of introspection. It's nice to share one's journey, because marketing is not really maths. So when you share journey, you learn with people who really understand marketing and who appreciate marketing. So it's great to be here. And I would say a marketing person would tend to kind of move towards being an entrepreneur a lot more than anybody else. Because a marketing person, if one is truly is, loves the challenges, because marketing is not really something which is a very, very defined scientific stuff. It's an art. It's something that you keep learning all your life. So if you love challenges, you love things which are not so predictable, if you love uncertainty, you will definitely love to be an entrepreneur. And which is one of the reasons which is why I'm here. 3 decades is a long time, I believe, in a professional's journey. There are 4 different phases, being an executive, where you, execute for others, being a manager, where you manage a team, look after projects, look after a certain kind of business, being a leader, where you kind of lead the organization, no matter which function you are in, to make sure that the business moves forward as a whole and not just your marketing function or whatever. And the last of that journey is being an entrepreneur. Many organizations provide for the leaders to be entrepreneurs within the organization, but it isn't easy for organizations. So many of us who love challenges, who like to evolve even further, because one has to keep evolving, otherwise one is dead as a professional. Right. So for that, you have to jump into an entrepreneurial mode sooner or later. And in fact, I would say 3 decades by standards of today is perhaps too late. People are joining in, jumping in even earlier. So I think it's a natural, organic process for me to move from various leadership roles now to try on my own.
See, with that experience, you have just started, and it is such an exciting journey. To start your own, to overcome your own challenges. As you said, that marketing and entrepreneurship is very much related, because uncertainty, there is an excitement, that is a dynamic function, and that is the similar attribute which you need to be an entrepreneur. So what is your company is all about, Mr. Sanjeev? Terra Health.
I would love to share. I'm of course really excited about
that.
It's not something like what I've done in the past. Compared to that, is something really small. And it's just the beginning. And like a lot of my friends and a lot of other ex-colleagues who are still in senior positions and so on have told me, it will take a long time, and maybe 5 years later also you realize that it's not working and you'll have to do something else, etc., etc. So there are a lot of ifs and buts going around, but Just to be crisp, it's something to do with my last stint. I was in Kerala. And as you know, Kerala is all about being earthy, being natural, and Ayurvedic, and so on, and traditional practices, and so on and so forth. Yes. And at the same time, the pandemic stuff. So it all came together for me. I felt we need to do something about being natural, about being connected to the earth. Not necessarily about medicines, but something which is part of our daily lives. And which is the other thing that I'm very particular about, that something which is part of my life on a daily basis is something that I can consistently do. If I have to go out of my, if I have to do something out of my way, I'll do for some time, and then it'll become too impractical and too difficult for me to do it, and then it'll fall by the wayside, right? So my thing is all about an online marketplace, a health marketplace. Purely a health marketplace, not a general marketplace, with specially curated partners who are into healthy food, everyday food, but healthy food, natural food, something which is grown in pure environments, like in the hills of Uttarakhand, in Himalayas, or in tribal areas of Tamil Nadu, or in in the green farms of Wayanad of Kerala. So everyday food, it could be dried tomato, it could be dried papaya, it could be apple jam from Mukteshwar, where apple is naturally grown. It could be the spices from Wayanad in Kerala, which is like black pepper and clove and cinnamon and so on and so forth. So I've tied up with 4 or 5 different partners.
Okay.
Who are really passionate about natural spices, natural herbs, natural foods, and Ayurvedic medicines and so on. And then we also, all of us, I would say, and you'd know better, of course, you're far younger than where I am, is that the younger generation is far more evolved in terms of their choices as far as food habits are concerned. So, they choose carefully, they're willing to spend money for something which is authentic and pure and good. So that is what, those are the people that I'm kind of trying to target, the millennials, not just by age, but by how heart. They evolved in terms of choice. Yeah. Millennials by heart. Millennials in terms of their lifestyle. So it's for those, and I guess there is enough and more if you're authentic and if you really provide products which are genuinely good.
It sounds interesting, Sanjeev, and I think that is the need of our people. Yeah. Moving forward, they are health conscious, and they are very conscious, as you said, about their lifestyle, about their choices, what they are using in a daily life. And I wish all the very best, to reach out to the people, and to right people to reach out to you, because it is, it is a win-win situation for both, right?
That's right, absolutely. Yes. And that's one of the basics of marketing. If it is not win-win for the customer, you can't really sell what you make. You have to make what the customer wants.
So I'm again coming to the marketing part here. You have worked with big marketing budgets in your career, right? Now, from moving from big marketing budgets to startup, where every budget needs a check. You need to be very focused about your budget. So what is your experience with the narrowing marketing budgets, and how challenging it is to effectively not only to reach to the target audience, but also to make them your brand advocates?
Yeah, see, it's something really I've kind of faced that throughout my life, throughout the 3 decades. I would tend to believe, and I have almost always said, and that I'm a human being first before being a marketer or before being a professional. The point I'm trying to make is that, the budgets at Hero MotoCorp or budgets at Hyundai, since we're launching Hyundai, were, if I were to say, unlimited in that sense. But like I said in the beginning, it's about ownership. And if the budgets are big, doesn't mean that you can just splurge, or you can forget about smaller details. I've always worshipped my work. and I believe I need to own those budgets even if they are not mine. So it's all about being absolutely thoughtful, careful, and detail oriented no matter what size of the budget is. So even in Hero Motor Corp and Hyundai and elsewhere, I've always tried to save every little rupee. I've always tried to fight, and I'm kind of infamous for that with channels and with newspapers and with media agencies for fighting for everything and quarreling with them on a daily basis as far as my work is concerned. So I fight for every rupee, and hopefully that will come to good use when I kind of start my own journey or when I have to kind of work within very, very limited means. And the other thing which is important that we need to understand is that when the budgets are big, even that small portion that you're able to save is a lots of money. Mm-hmm. And you can put it to a different use, which will help the business and which will also help you shine as well at the same time. So I have interestingly found that if I save money out of 1,000 crore that I have, even that 1% is 10 crores and I can put it somewhere, my boss will wonder, where did this come from? And he'll be happy about it, which will be good for the business and will be good for myself. So I think, you have to be careful about every rupee, whether the budget is big or small. And that's the philosophy that's kind of I've lived with all my life. And hopefully that'll be help me as I go forward in my new chapter in life.
Definitely that is going to help you. Yeah. Because see here how I mean you have just put the light on the ownership part. You know, amazing. Yeah. Part is on the ownership, how closely you take that budget on your own. So the responsibility, yeah, the sense of responsibility which you had and which one should have towards any budget, that is going to define the results in multifolds, because now you're responsible for the result. What kind of campaigns you do to reach out to your target customers at this point of time, and what are your most preferred medium of marketing to reach out to them, Sanjeev?
Look, it sounds cliché-tic, but the answer is very simple in these days. Mm-hmm. Particularly since, of course, it is not the campaign or the medium to begin with, it's the customer to begin with, right? Right. So you have to define your customers absolutely sharply. Mm-hmm. You must know your market very, very closely. Not even closely, you have to know your market intimately. Mm-hmm. The way you try to know your girlfriend, or the girlfriend tries to know her boyfriend, you have to know your customer as closely, or maybe even more. Mm-hmm. Because girlfriends, boyfriends, it's a transitional relationship. But with the customer, I would love to forge a long-term relationship. So I must know my customer intimately. And once I know my customer intimately, I know what she or he does, where he or she consumes, what's her lifestyle, and so on and so forth. The campaign and the media comes after that. Uh-huh. So what has got simplified as we speak today, and that something which started even before the pandemic, and through the pandemic got even more sharper, is the fact that, of course, if you have more money, you can go anywhere. If you don't really have unlimited monies, digital is good enough for you to reach out to your customer. And when I say digital, I don't just mean social media. Digital means the deployment of the technology. So digital marketing is just one part of technology. So if you deploy the technology, which includes a CRM, which includes how you are able to respond back to your customer quickly, how you're able to get all the data of the customer and make sure that you know your customer better. So it is not just a digital marketing part, but the entire technology behind it. The CRM technology, the data analytics part of it, the media part of it, all that technology put together has simplified the life of the marketer, if you ask me, or of a business person. Because you don't really have to go after the TV channels or newspapers. I'm not saying they are redundant, but I'm saying that if your budget is limited, you can prioritize. And even without the TVs and the newspapers, you can do well. Not just survive, but you can do well. So that is where I am. And campaigns also have got simplified. If you look at it, what goes even in this day and age, with people being really strategic, people being really sharp with technology, people mm-hmm. knowing the customers really well. There are only a few campaigns that go viral. Sometimes it's not even a campaign, it's just an image or a small story or a small video which really goes viral even without the maker of it realizing it.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, what goes viral is something which is natural, which is from the heart, which is mm-hmm. genuine.
Mm-hmm.
So the campaign is all about being genuine with your customer,
mm-hmm.
Telling him or her what he or she wants to listen to and mm-hmm. not you what you want to tell him or her,
mm-hmm.
and use digital. So the, mm-hmm. both from the content perspective and from media planning perspective is very simple.
Mm-hmm. Right. During this course of period, Sanjeev, what were the major roadblocks you have faced, in the last 1 year of your time? And how did you that?
I think important question. And I would say there are two parts to it, Devlina. One is that the roadblocks, while we keep celebrating the fact that there are too many roadblocks and people have done well, mm-hmm. we must realize the roadblocks when Henry Ford thought of a car,
mm-hmm.
and customers not even aware what car it is, and he famously said that if we were to ask customers, they would have said a faster pull-up cart and not mm-hmm. a car, because they were not even aware of what a car is, right? So the mm-hmm. roadblocks then were far higher and far more difficult than where we are today.
Mm-hmm.
There were no investors then, there were no venture capitalists then to give you money for mm-hmm. you to burn.
Right.
There were no share markets for you to go and float an IPO and get the money and then invest it. The communication channels were so long that for one message to reach somebody, it would take months or maybe years and so on and so forth. All that data analytics, technology, everything is there now. It's just mm-hmm. about how involved you are, how engaged you are, and how motivated you are. So mm-hmm. to my mind, the roadblocks for any one of us, particularly after 30 years of working and mm-hmm. being used to a luxury lifestyle and being used to having a large team and being used to having all the support systems and everything else and being used to, being fawned upon, etc., etc. I think the roadblocks are more individual than professional.
Okay.
Which is basically two, which is self-belief and perseverance.
Mm-hmm.
You've got to believe in yourself that you can do it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's applicable whether you're working for somebody else or for yourself. Mm-hmm. And perseverance. Because like I said, a lot of my friends keep telling me even now it'll take you 5 years, and even after 5 years you won't know whether you've done well or not. You might have to junk it after 5 years as well, and so on.
Mm-hmm.
So you've got to have that self-belief and you've got to have that perseverance.
Mm-hmm.
And why I'm saying this is because a lot of us, I'm of course reasonably old or sufficiently old, but a lot of my young friends, they want the results very quickly. And they keep looking at all these LinkedIn stories about how somebody's become a unicorn in just a year or so. And somebody suddenly having got an investment and so on and so forth. So the illusions, we have to cast away those illusions.
Mm-hmm.
And for that, you need to have that perseverance.
Mm-hmm.
It'll take years, it'll take a lot of pain, and it is not unusual. We shouldn't say that it is extraordinary, we are facing a lot of pain. It was always there. But we want the results too quickly now. And we think, Freshworks has done well, listed on the NASDAQ, I can also do it tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
So, it doesn't happen tomorrow. You got to have that perseverance and you got to have the self-belief. So those are the roadblocks. And of course, it's easy to say that we can overcome them, but the fact remains that they're all inside you. So yes, you can overcome.
I love the answer because major roadblocks, not only in the but anywhere in the place, I mean, no matter what, the major roadblocks are inside. So it is inside out. If you have overcome it, and you know, as you said, it is the easiest part because it's inside, but I feel it is the toughest part also because it's inside.
Absolutely.
It is just you have to accept
most
it.
Most of us are not willing to look inside. We're so quick to blame things outside.
That's right. And also, as you rightly pointed out, that we need results very quickly.
Yeah.
Forgetting the part of the process, that the process has a certain timeline, and that timeline has to, it has to, you know, it, you have to, you know, go through with all these things, and then there is a result. There are examples where the, you know, as you said, in LinkedIn, there are stories floating around. That is fine. That is good to, you know, feel motivated towards, feel optimistic towards your result. But at the same time, understanding the reality, understanding where we are. And with that, perseverance and patience is, you know, something which you need to keep in mind that is there.
Absolutely.
I love the answer. So as a marketing strategy expert, Sanjeev, give us 3 actionable tips, you know, to create and craft, you know, awesome marketing campaigns.
So actually, I'm a believer of the fact that every situation is different from the other. And tips is something that I don't really believe in, because, you know, I think it is as per the, like I said, it has to be as per the customer, as per the brand, and as per the situation. And as per the people behind that brand. And every situation is different from the other. Same brand today with the same customers, you need one kind of strategy, and same brand with the same customer tomorrow, you will need another kind of strategy, and so on. But I think in terms of tips, yes, like I said, long-term relationship, believe in long-term relationship, number one. Number two, it's all about customer experience. Please remember, in this day and age, in social media, the bad news travels like wildfire. Even if one customer is not happy about it, you've lost it. So make sure that you satisfy each and every customer. Don't take even one customer for granted. Number three, it's really misleading to have your ears to the internet. Please have your ears to the ground as usual. Not as it was said, the earlier phase of having ears to the ground. I think that is absolutely critical. We are too stuck to our laptops and our mobile phones and our data and what Google Analytics and so on and so forth. I think it's extremely important to go out there, visit the market at random, meet customers as random. Believe me, I've been to customers' homes as well in my last job. And sometimes you're actually driven to tears with their stories, with what they share with you, and so on and so forth. So there's nothing like meeting the customer at his home or her home, basically in his turf, you know, so that he's comfortable, so that he's open, so that he's nice and kind, so that he believes that you really come to listen to him. So I think there's nothing that can ever substitute talking to a customer in his own turf. Sitting with him, spending time, having tea or coffee with him is still, even after all this technology and tools and everything else, that's, to my mind, is real marketing.
So a real marketing campaign will only be fulfilled when you're really connected to the consumer. I mean, in a real, rather than only to digital, it has to be, you know, grounded. I loved, you know, just stay, your ear has to be on the ground rather than on the internet. There are a lot of misleading things which might, you know, mislead you as a leader through the internet, but it's better, you know, to be confident, meet your customers, and strategize your campaign accordingly.
Yeah.
So what are the 3 major qualities when it comes to choosing an agency partner? So agency, when I say, it's media and creative agency partner in marketing perspective.
It's a very difficult situation, because agency and media partners, particularly nowadays, in the age of everything getting consolidated, and you are having global networks and so on and so forth, there are too many layers within the agencies and within the the media agencies as well as the creative agencies. They have too many layers, and since it's a people intensive business, there are too many people out there.
Yes.
Yeah, and not all of them are connected with you as you would like them to be.
Mm-hmm.
So I think the three tips to my mind, keeping that in mind, is one, which is true for the marketer as well, mm-hmm. is that the agencies and their leadership must believe in long-term relationship with the client.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and not just transaction. You know, it's not just about my billing this quarter, or it's not just my billing this year and so on, but a long-term relationship. And it's very difficult, Evelyn. It sounds easy, but it's very difficult. Because if you look at the agency leadership, mm-hmm. they jump every year from one agency to the other and so on and so forth. Mm-hmm. Their designations change very fast and so on mm-hmm. and so forth. But they're not thinking beyond a year. They are absolutely perfectly satisfied with having done well this year.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it completely screws up the next year, doesn't matter. So you choose the client this year.
Mm-hmm.
If you lose the client next year, doesn't matter, because I'm not there next year. I'll be in some other agency on a higher position. So mm-hmm. this client doesn't matter. So mm-hmm. it's a difficult thing, but somehow if agencies come together and decide it's about long-term relationship with the client or with the brand, mm-hmm. it really help everyone. Two, the agencies need to know the business, which means the brand mm-hmm. and the customers, really closely. They leave it to the brand manager
mm-hmm.
and sometimes it's lost in the transmission, mm-hmm. Sometimes it's lost in the brief and so on and so forth. Agency must also, like anybody else, including myself, travel and meet the customers, meet people,
mm-hmm.
know the real India, grow culturally, grow socially, grow emotionally.
Mm-hmm.
So I think they really need to know the business and really need to know the customers.
Mm-hmm.
Third important aspect is the ever-changing world of technology. I think agencies need to be really with it as far as future trends are concerned, technology is concerned, new practices are concerned. That's evolving very, very fast. So if you're lost in day-to-day operations and not having your finger on what's happening around the world, then you're totally lost. So I think that's something that agencies have to invest in. New stuff all the while.
Right. So to sum it up here, it's being accountable as an agency and look for long-term relationship, not just look for the transactional relationship that this is the campaign and this is the time which I have to. So it is like a proper partnership relationship which an agency also should, you know, look forward towards any brand, because the brand is successful, it is a success of the agencies, and a constant upgradation of technology and team and your resources is must.
Right.
Super. So with that, with those great inputs, Sanjeev, now we are moving to a little lighter section, which is a rapid fire round. One of my most interesting, part. I enjoy this section here. Yeah, so where you have to answer in one word or as minimum word as possible.
Yeah.
So
I'm not really a man of few words, but I'll try.
I'm sure you can. What is leadership for you?
Compassionate leadership.
What is the book you're planning to read?
I'm trying to read myself as much as I can.
Wow, I think that is like we spend our whole life without reading our own mind or our own self, what exactly we are. Who has been a greatest influence on you?
My father, because he's made me the human being that I am.
Wow, super. When are you most inspired?
I'm most inspired when my wife says something positive about me.
Super.
Because she's very critical.
And you need, Sanjeev, you need some good critics at your own space so that, I mean, you get the right feedbacks, you know.
You bet, yeah.
Yeah. What is the best compliment you have ever received?
So those who know me closely, Devlina, they really love me.
Mm-hmm.
So I keep receiving a lot of compliments from very few people, but those very few people keep complimenting me all the while.
What does creativity means to you?
Creativity means that you got to be up every morning with a fresh perspective.
That's a great one-liner, Sanjeev. A fresh perspective on every morning. So what is an important life lesson for someone to learn?
That life isn't a bed of roses. There are a lot of thorns all around. But even when they prick you and you see blood oozing, don't panic. There is no time to panic. There is no reason to panic. You got to move on.
Amazing answer. So with that insight, we are just out of the rapid fire zone. And with amazing insights, great points, super inspiring. And I would love you to, tell about, what is your message for the aspiring brand managers, market leaders, and especially startup owners and business owners?
Like I said, believe in yourself. That's the message, as simple as that. Believe in yourself and keep moving forward. The point is, and we need to think about it very carefully. The point is, unless and until you see a lot of doors in front of you, or you come across a lot of doors as you move forward, unless and until you push that door, unless and until you give that door a nudge, you won't know whether it's open or is it bolted from inside. So you've got to do that. You've got to push. You've got to give a nudge to things. Dreaming is not enough. In my point of view, thinking is such a waste of time. You've got to get up, make sure that you push that door. If it's closed or bolted from inside, doesn't matter, move on, move to the next door, give it a nudge. So give it a push. Because like I said, if you don't give it a push, you won't know whether it is, open or whether it is bolted from inside. So keep pushing that door. Keep pushing that door one after the other, one after the other, one after the other. Because unless and you push, the door won't open. And if it won't open, you can't get inside. So, and you have to get inside just that one door. But you have to keep pushing.
Right. Amazing insights, Sanjeev. Very relatable and extremely practical. I felt, your experience of 3 decades that reflected in the whole conversation here, Sanjeev. So as you kept telling that I am, a little older to start your own, but your experience, it is going to add a lot of value here. That is a reflection. Otherwise, as you said, people are very quick to, towards the result and all. So the experience are going to add a lot of value, and you have added a lot of value to the platform Icons Behind Brand and to our who are from the startup communities, business owner community, marketing fraternity, advertising, student from B schools, and they need a lot of insights as well as a lot of inspiration from people like you.
My pleasure.
And thank you for your time and valuable insights to us. And it was wonderful having you here. I totally enjoyed the conversation.
Same here. Thanks a lot.